Before the light bulb, we rose with the sun, were guided at night by the stars, ate dinner around a fire, and read by candlelight. Today, we spend more than 90% of our day indoors, away from unfiltered sunlight and exposed to artificial lights that are ultimately wrecking our lives. Your body is at a constant war against your smartphone, TV, computer, and those harsh fluorescent lights that are at work and school. The cells of your body are constantly battling the signals sent from these devices. And are trying to adjust to this artificial environment that we have created in just the past century. Humans were genetically perfected through thousands of years of genetic breeding to crave sunlight. Hell, almost every single organism on Earth responds to and craves sunlight in some way. We were not genetically perfected to thrive in these modern artificial environments, and our minds and bodies are aching from the consequences. Prolonged exposure to artificial light negatively impacts health through increases in irritability, daytime sleepiness, difficulty concentrating, and poor quality of sleep. So that means that your post-work headache, eye strain, and grumpiness is probably heavily influenced by the fact that you've been inside all day, staring at your computer and scrolling on Instagram, and not outside frolicking in the sunlight. To combat headaches and fatigue, we usually examine our diet, exercise, and sleep schedule, which are all very important things to consider. But up until the past few years, we hadn't considered how lighting could affect all of these things. Now, we flip a switch, press a button, and stare at a screen without even thinking about the light that is emitted. But even if lighting is acknowledged, we typically don't scrutinize its wavelength, intensity, color, or temperature. In the past few years or so, a handful of scientists really have started to ask and investigate these questions, which is why recently we've begun to hear about the effects of lighting, like how we should avoid screens right before going to bed. But why does this matter? And how does this really work? Without getting into the nitty-gritty technical details, pretty much every light sends a signal that triggers a cascade of events that influence our body's circadian rhythms, which is our body's internal clock that regulates our 24-hour sleep-wake cycle that also coincides with the sun. And different lights send different signals that influence these rhythms in a certain way. For example, bright light like the sun and LEDs cue wakefulness, and dim/no light cue sleepiness. So I got involved with lighting research and kind of became obsessed with lamps like a moth after I was diagnosed with narcolepsy in 2016. I wanted to find a healthier alternative to Adderall to help alleviate me from my constant state of sleepiness. I already had a basic understanding of the relationship between light and sleepiness, so I began to become more aware of my environmental light, and I began to use a bright light lamp every day. And after doing this for about only 1 week, I started to feel like my old energetic self again. And the difference was night and day. So since my little lamp helped keep me awake and alert, I figured that it could help my fellow college students as well. Us college students are the most sleep deprived than any other age group. We see sleep deprivation as a badge of honor, and we pull all-nighters to help meet our academic and social demands. But not only are college students sleep deprived, our feelings of sleepiness largely depend on our environment, which is why college students are more likely to fall asleep in dimly lit lecture halls. Yeah, we're all familiar with that. So with a little help and encouragement from my research mentor, Dr. June Pilcher, I ambitiously decided to create my own research study to see if bright light could help keep college students awake and to help them cope with their sleep deprivation. So in my study, I took 30 college students, partially sleep deprived them, and controlled for their environmental light for 1 hour. Within that hour, I made them read a boring book, measured their states of sleepiness, and they did several tasks that measured their organization. They did several tasks that measured their reaction time, their attention, and their self-control. So when we were looking at the results, we were pleasantly surprised with what we saw. I mean, I made college students more sleep deprived than they already were. So out of the 30 students that I partially sleep deprived, 15 of them were only exposed to fluorescent lights, and the other 15 were exposed to this bright green light for 1 hour. Pretty bright, right? So when we were looking at the preliminary results, we were not expecting to see a positive effect after just 20 minutes of bright light exposure. The two graphs that you can see here are the results for a task that measured executive function. And executive function is the part of the brain that controls for things like organization, planning, and self-control. So as you can see here, the students that were exposed to 20 minutes of bright light, they saw a significant improvement in the number of errors that they made, and they had a significantly faster reaction time. In comparison, the students that were exposed to only fluorescent light, they showed no improvement in the number of errors that they made, and they had a slower reaction time. On top of that, the students that were exposed to fluorescent lights, they were more likely to fall asleep, and they were significantly sleepier. Whereas the students that were exposed to the bright light, not a single one of them fell asleep, and they maintained their levels of sleepiness. So this is important not only because it shows that bright light can help keep you awake and alert when you're already sleep deprived, but it also does something that caffeine fails to do, which is improving one's self-control. You know, after drinking a few cups of coffee, most of us might have experienced the feeling of feeling wired, jittery, and impulsive, kind of like this. Yeah, we're all familiar with the feeling. And yes, caffeine has shown to increase a simple reaction time, but it also is shown to increase the number of errors and tasks that measure things like self-control. So, as I explained earlier, bright light helps to keep you awake without making you feel jittery and impulsive. This works because bright light is similar to the sun, so it stops the release of the hormone melatonin. Melatonin makes you feel sleepy and is released in your brain when you're exposed to dim light or whenever it's dark. So since most artificial light is not as bright as the sun, it actually triggers the release of the hormone melatonin, which is why those college students were more likely to fall asleep in those dimly lit lecture halls. So, for everyone to start feeling better and more productive, you can start by channeling your inner savage, by getting back in contact with our natural environment. Go outside for about 20 minutes in the morning each day without sunglasses or sunscreen. When you work inside, try to work in a room with lots of windows and great natural light. But if you can't get any natural sunlight exposure in throughout your day, it is best to use a bright light lamp for about 1 hour. If you start to do this, you'll start to remain awake all day without having to take any caffeine. And you might even start to feel happier and more productive as well. So the next time you get sleepy, put down that cup of coffee and pick up a lamp. I'm Emily Scircle, and thank you for listening to my TED Talk.